Salam everyone, kya haal hai? Now this video is on inverse function. Inverse functions are those functions that maps the range back onto the domain. For example, if you have a function that was taking the values a of a as an input and giving you output as b, inverse function is a function hoga that takes the same output and gives you the input back. So if in an inverse function b is an input, then you get the same a as an output. Such kinds of functions are known as inverse function. So what is this inverse function doing? It is mapping the range back onto the domain. For example, if I have a function f of x equals to x plus 2, now I know when I'll insert 5 in this function, I'll get 7, right? Now inverse function is a function in which when 7 is inserted, it will get you back the value of 5. You need to come up with that function, and that particular function is the inverse function of f of x. Therefore, what you will do is, you know that function f of x is x plus 2. The first step is to replace this f of x with y and make x the subject. Y minus 2, right? Now for your inverse function, replace the positions of x and y, so this would be your inverse function. So here I have this inverse function. Now when you insert 7 in it, you will get back 5. This is a simple kind of inverse function. Yeah, so let's do one of the example. If you have function g of x, which is 2x minus 3 over x minus 1, the domain given to you is x belongs to all real values and x cannot take the value of 1. Why? Because when you insert x as 1, the function will be discontinuous at that point, because in the denominator you will get 0. Now you need to find g inverse. Step number 1, replace g of x with x, g of x with y, 2x minus 3 over x minus 1. Now you need to make x a subject. So if you simplify this, you get x minus 1 times y, 2x minus 3. Take x common. So you get 3 minus y over 2 minus y, or you can also write this as y minus 3 over y minus 2. Now in order to write inverse function, you will replace y with x. So this would be y equals to x minus 3 over x minus 2. Your g inverse function of x would be x minus 3 over x minus 2. Alright, so this is your g inverse function. And for what values of x is it defined? It is defined for all real values except x equals to 2. X cannot be equal to 2, because when you insert 2, this function will be discontinuous. So let's look at some graphs of the inverse function. When the function itself, when the sketch of a function is given to you, or the equation is given to you, and you are being asked to sketch the inverse of a function. Now inverse of a function are always the reflection of a function in the line y equals to x. So first of all, if the sketch of a function is not made, you will be making a sketch. Now in this example, let's say y equals to x squared plus 1, the sketch is given to you, where this point is 0, 1. Now in order to make the reflection of this function, that reflected function would be the inverse function. And in what an inverse function does is, if you have a coordinate 0, 1 on the function, so it will be 1, 0 on your inverse function. You have this point, so the inverse of this point would be 1, 0. And now you need to make a reflection of this function. So the reflection of this function would look something like this. This would be your inverse function. It's a reflection in the line, it is the reflection of the function in the line y equals to x. Similarly, if you have this equation f of x equals to 2x, it is passing through this point. So 0, 0 inverse would be 0, 0. This point would be same over here, and you need to make a reflection of this line. So for this part, the reflection is this, and for this part, the reflection would be this. Now, if you are asked to find the inverse function, you know that if your function is y equals to x square plus 1, you need to make x the subject, and you will get y minus 1 square root. Alright, now this has plus and minus sign both, but both of them together cannot be function. We have a discussion on this, that plus root x along with minus root x, this is not a complete function. You need to either take one of it. So this, the reflection of the function given to you, your function is defined for x greater than or equal to 0. So the inverse function equation would be positive square root x minus 1, because your function was defined for x greater than or equal to 0. Similarly, if you have a function of y equals to 2x, the inverse, for the inverse you need to make y x the subject and then replace your x with y, and you get x over 2. That's the equation of your inverse function. So this is the inverse function 1 over 2. Now, to summarize this, whatever I have said, I have written down over here. Only one-to-one function will have an inverse. So if the question says that you need to find an inverse, remember that you inverse of a function is only possible if the function is one-to-one function. The graph of the function and its inverse are reflection of each other in the line y equals to x. That is, the point AB, A comma B, would become B comma A on your inverse function. The range of the function is the domain of its inverse, and the domain of a function is the range of its inverse. So if you know the domain of a function, the domain of a function would be same as the range of the inverse function. And if you know the range of the inverse function, it will be the same as the range of the function, or vice versa. You can say that if you know the range of the function, that will be the domain of the inverse function. And it is not necessary that the graph of f of x and f inverse of x meet, but when they meet, they will intersect at y equals to x. So for example, in the example that we just saw, the domain was x greater than or equal to 0, right? So the range of this function is y greater than or equal to 0. The range of this function was y greater than or equal to 1. Therefore, the domain of this inverse function is x greater than or equal to 1. Not necessarily they will intersect, but if they do intersect, they will intersect at line y equals to x. Alright? So you can observe that they are reflection of each other in the line y equals to x. Now let's look at this example. The question is that a function is y equals to 2x plus 1, we need to sketch its inverse. So y equals to 2x plus 1, 2x plus 1 would look something like this, where the graph would intersect at 1, intersect the y-axis at 1, and the x-intercept would be minus half. So this will be, if you want to sketch the inverse function, we know that it will be a reflection of the line in the line y equals to x. But for this simple function, you can also find the inverse function directly. You will replace y, f of x with y, make x the subject, and you get x minus 1 over 2, x, y minus 1 over 2, and the inverse function would be x minus 1 over 2. If you write it in the standard form, you get half times x minus half, meaning half is your gradient. And if you just take two points on the line, you will notice that this point 0 comma 1 would become 1 comma 0, and this point minus half comma 0 would become 0 comma minus half. So if you want to make the inverse function, you will just take the inverse of the two points and draw the sketch the graph in such a way that it looks like the inverse function. It looks like the reflection. So this is your inverse function. That's your main function. This is your line y equals to x. So it must look like the reflection. So 0 comma 1 become 1 comma 0, and this point would become minus half 0 comma minus half. 0 comma minus half. ठीक है, तो ये रिफ्लेक्शन जैसा लगना चाहिए. Now let's say you have this function f of x equals to x square, and this is defined for x greater than equal to 0. You need to find an inverse function. So y equals to x square, just a second. So y is equals to x square. Now when you make x a subject, you will have plus minus square root of y, but they both can't together be function. Either it will be plus square root y or it will be minus square root y, right? So f inverse would be, then you will replace x and y, you get x over here, yahan pe plus sign aegi, y, because the domain of the function is x greater than equal to 0, and we had a discussion that if the domain of the function is greater than equal to 0, then the range of the function must be greater than equal to 0, and by greater than equal to 0 means either the range would be 0 or above 0, a positive value. That is why the inverse function would have plus root x instead of minus root x. Now in the next part, you are being asked to sketch f of x and f inverse of x on the same sketch. So f of x, let me give it a quick sketch. So this is a graph of x squared for x greater than equal to 0. Now we know that it will be a reflection in the line y equals to x. The inverse function would be a reflection of the function in the line y equals to x. Now 0 comma 0 would be 0 comma 0, and if the inverse function and f of x are going to intersect, they will intersect at the line y equals to x, and you have to draw simply a reflection, so something like this. So these kinds of function will have the equation in terms of plus root x. Now let's look at this example where our function is the same, x square, but it is defined for x less than equal to 0. So if I am going to make the inverse of this function, I'll make x the subject, same steps, but when I'm going to write the inverse function, I'll replace x with y. Now here I have to decide whether I have to place a plus sign or a minus sign, and that would be decided based upon looking at the domain of the function. Your domain of the function is less than equal to 0, so the range of the function must also be less than equal to 0. If you are asked to sketch the same graph, but this time for the domain of less than equal to 0, this is what the sketch would look like. Your y equals to x square graph for x less than equal to 0 would look something like this. This is your x square graph. And we know that the inverse function is the reflection of this function in the line y equals to x. So the inverse would be something like this. The equation would be minus root x. Get it? So let's look at some other examples now. If you have a function f of x equals to x square minus 1, by the way, it's always advisable to convert the quadratic function in the completing square form. Alright, so f of x in our case is can be written as x minus 0 the whole thing square plus minus 1, that's the completing square form. ठीक है, अब इसकी range find करनी है हमें. Now the range of f of x, if you just visualize this graph, these points are the turning points. So this quadratic function had a turning point of 0, minus 1. So 0, minus 1 here. And the x-intercept would be 1, 0. So now you have a pretty decent idea about how your graph would look like. Let me sketch it for you. So this is your sketch for y equals to f of x equals to x squared minus 1. Now by looking at the graph, you can answer this. You can find the range of f of x. The range is from the minimum value to the highest value. This graph would keep on going upward for real values of x, for the values of x. So the minimum point is minus 1. So the range of this function, range of f of x would be simply f of x is greater than equal to minus 1. Now you are being asked to find f inverse. In order to find f inverse, you'll use the same thing. Y equals to x square minus 1, you'll make x the subject, and this would come out to be y plus 1 square root. Now the last step would be to replace y with x, but together they can't be, this is not a function. Alright, the inverse function of f of x, f inverse of x, would be found by looking at the domain of the function. So the domain of the function is x greater than equal to 0. So the range of the inverse function must be greater than equal to 0. That is why it will be plus square root of x plus 1. ठीक है, अब इसी ग्राफ पे यू नीड टू स्केच f inverse. Now as I said, inverse function are the reflection in the line y equals to x. Okay, so let's say the function is x plus 1 the whole thing square, and it is defined for x less than equal to minus 2. Ab ye completing square form aapko given hai, right? So let's say f of x is x plus 1 the whole thing square, so turning points aap easily find kar sakte hain yahan se. The turning points of this quadratic equation would be minus 1, 0. So if you give it a quick sketch, minus 1, 0 is this point. But they are saying that this function is defined for x less than equal to minus 2. So minus 2 pe koi particular value hogi is function ki. Minus 2 jab plug in karoge yahan pe, minus 2 plus 1, minus 1 the whole thing square 1, right? So the corresponding value of the function at minus 2 is 1. And you will have this kind of quadratic sketch. Okay, so if you figure out range from here, your range of the function would be f of x greater than equal to 1. That's for the first part. Now in second part, you are being asked to find f inverse and state the domain. F inverse would be, in order to find the f inverse, you will replace f of x with y और x को सब्जेक्ट बनाओगे, so x would be equal to 1 plus minus square root y But you know that you cannot have plus and minus both. So f inverse of x would be, now how would you decide? आपको domain जो है function का वो x less than equal to minus 2 है, which means that the range of the inverse function must be less than equal to minus 2. ठीक है, and this would be 1 minus square root of x. अच्छा, now you need to sketch. अच्छा, इसका ये जो inverse function है इसका domain क्या होगा? The domain of this function, the domain of the inverse function is the range of the main function. So the range of this function was f of x, therefore the domain would be, so the domain is, domain of f inverse of x is greater than equal to 1. All right. The next part says sketch f of x and f inverse of x on the same graph. So in order to sketch, you first of all you will be drawing y equals to x ki line, and then you, this point which is minus 2 comma 1 would be on your graph on the inverse function. This point would be 1 comma minus 2. This point was minus 2 comma 1 and this point would be 1 comma minus 2, and you need to draw a function that is, that looks like the reflection of the function in the line y equals to x. Okay, so let's look at this example in which a function is given and they are saying that x is greater than equal to k, and you need to find the least value of k for which f of x has an inverse. Remember this, only 1 to 1 function will have an inverse. So by looking at the equation, you might say that okay, this is a quadratic graph, but it must be restricted by the domain so that this become a 1 to 1 function. So if I give a quick sketch of y equals to x minus 2 the whole thing square, I know that the turning points are 2 comma 3. So 2 comma 3 is somewhere here, and it's a minimum curve, so the quadratic graph would look something like this. This is for the function. अब इसका जो इनवर्स, इट्स अ 1 टू 1 फंक्शन, राइट? 1 टू 1 फंक्शन ओनली इफ आई रिस्ट्रिक्ट इट बाय द डोमेन. फंक्शन ये भी, फंक्शन तो ये पूरा हो सकता था, बट वो मेनी टू वन फंक्शन होता. 1 टू 1 फंक्शन वुड बी व्हेन इट्स रिस्ट्रिक्टेड बाय द डोमेन. या सो दिस इज अ 1 टू 1 फंक्शन. So what is the least value of k? The least value of k would be 2. Sahi hai? If you would have broken the function from here, or it would also be a 1 to 1 function, lekin least value would be when you restrict it from the turning point. Similarly, let's say you have another function g of x, x minus 2 the whole thing square plus 3. It's the same equation, but why is it a different function? Because it is defined for a different domain. And they are saying find the greatest value of k for which g of x is a 1 to 1 function. Now 1 to 1 function keh lo, ya phir you can say whether this g of x has an inverse. Theek hai? Again, give a quick sketch, figure out the turning points. 2 comma 3 is the turning point, but this time it is defined for x less than equal to k. Okay, so I'll be considering this part of the curve. So the turning point is 2 comma 3, and it's for the domain is less than equal to k. Now your k can be anywhere on this part of the curve, because so your k can be anywhere on this part of the curve, so that makes the function a 1 to 1 function. So what is the greatest value of k? This is your greatest value of k. So in this case also k would be 2, but the question type is different. Here it was x greater than equal to k, g of x is defined for x less than equal to k. When it was defined for x greater than equal to k, they were asking for the least value, and when it's defined for less than equal to k, they are asking for the greatest value. Remember, you can make your many to one function a 1 to 1 function by restricting its domain. Okay guys, so I hope this video tutorial was helpful for you.